We finally made it. Welcome to...
Round the Village.
Shut up.
Ha ha.
Hey, am I the only one who expected Bamboo Village to have more, booze? Whatever. I'm just happy it's not destroyed. Maybe now I can receive a nice warm welcome from the townspeople. That's not what I had in mind. Some defense. What happens if there's more than two people? Speaking of which, where's Zhao and Goro? Where am I? You're not gonna torture me, are you? Help me! Help me! Help me! Somebody! Help! Thank God, the governor called. No, there is no governor, but the moon people do verify my story with this crystal ball. Yes, apparently they didn't know the genie got out until I told them. When I ask about resealing the genie, they say they don't know how anymore. But not to worry, the Jawas, moon people, on the moon, are bound to know how to do it. And these guys even have a spaceship hidden away to get us there. Awesome. And they have a remote control that can call a ship to us. At least they did until they accidentally sold it in a bunch of fruit. Fine, I'll go get it. Okay, I'm going to get one of these names right. The town is... Coons. Dang it! Oh, shut up. And it looks like the town is destroyed. Of course! But look, there happens to be one survivor. I'm starting to see a trend here. I think the Dark Genie likes to watch survivors suffer. Well, at least this guy's a merchant, so I get an item shop right from the beginning. I tell him about the moonship crystal, and he tells me it might be in a shipwreck in the bottom of the sea, because it's used as a storage by the local merchants. Seeing as the wreck is a memorial to the late queen, that seems a bit... disrespectful. It's like building McDonald's on top of the Arizona at Pearl Harbor. He says this submarine will take me down to the ship. This will be easy. Don't start that again!
Lieutenant, take her down.
Diving officer, submerge the ship. Make the depth 150 feet.
5 degrees down
whales?
Bigger.
Load the torpedo bays, subpod crews, battle stations! Jiminy Christmas! It's a machine!
Launch subpods!
Subpods, please!
Fire!
We're free, all ahead full. Torpedoes!
Fire torpedoes!
We took a big hit down here and we're taking our water fast!
I don't want to be around when it hits the boilers!
You heard the lady, let's move!
All hands, man,
hang on!
Make your mark 20 degrees down angle.
Roger! 20 degrees down angle!
I'm behind you!
We're getting killed out here!
Fire!
Well, never say submarine travel is uneventful. I have to say, this dungeon also really impresses me. It's very different from anything else in the game. The really dark corridors and the piano music, it gives a very depressing atmosphere. It's almost like Bioshock. The enemies even have a nice under-the-sea theme. Heck, even the back floor is entered by riding giant fish.
No.
Oh yeah, and Zhao has a joke slingshot called Steve. It says funny things. No, not that Steve! A new kind of switch blocks my path. It's new ally time! To the surface! Ugh, there's gotta be an easy way to travel. Okay, you know the drill. Build buildings, add stuff, get prizes. Go! This person gives me a fish and some ice. This guy locks his door. You jerk. And this lady tells me the future. Oh, cool. So you're gonna read my palm, look at some cards, and...
My eyes! My eyes!
Officer, I'd like to report a harassment in... Wait. You're giving me a search warrant? For Joker's house? You're just giving away search warrants? Awesome! Best police officer ever! Hey, can I have that gun? I'm sure it'd help me with my quest, and... Okay, fine, I'll wait till the next game to get a gun. Okay, so I go to Joker's house... Not that Joker. So Joker is the town gem expert, but he doesn't have the moon crystal thingy. But he is looking for another crystal called Life Sphere. It's a magic gem that gives immortality to whoever possesses it. However, it also makes that person lose the one thing they love most. But since Joker doesn't love anything, the worst he can lose is his shop. Why is he telling me this? I don't know. Hey, let's go visit the Kings. I bet he's got money. I actually like this guy. He seems to know he's in a video game, and as soon as the main character shows up, he's expecting a reward. If I were him, I'd try giving Tone one of those bags of exploding money. But the king tries to pawn off something else. Something more of a nuisance. A lamp! Oops. What? Oh great, now we're all gonna die.
To command, to control!
Nope, let's try that again. Judging by her violent reaction, I'm guessing Ruby doesn't like to be summoned pointlessly. After explaining the whole story of the Dark Genie, Ruby agrees to join our party, saying he is giving a bad name to genies everywhere.
Hey!
No, wait. A new ally is nice and everything, but since you're a genie, can I get 3 wishes? I could end everything right now. No, fine, we won't have a game. Now that I have Ruby, I can get a reward out of Jake here.
Gameplay mechanic!
Get out of the screen! Some of the events won't give rewards if you do them in the wrong order, such as building the Norm item shop before restoring Pike's house, or building Jake's house without having Ruby here to help extort things. When I finish the town, the sheriff wants to give me another reward.
Ooh,
is it a search warrant? A police car? A gun? Oh, a macho sword. Thanks. If you've been paying attention, you may have noticed those little red boxes all around the towns. These appear as you build things and contain different items. It is also the only way for your characters to level up. If you give someone a Fruit of Eden, it increases their health, and if you give someone a food item, it increases their defense. For instance, Tone eats donuts, Zhao eats fish candy, Ruby eats parfaits, Heavy eats sandwiches, and Goro eats... grass cakes? That's disgusting! Why can't you eat something more edible? Like cheesecake!
Oh, cheesecake munching on a cheesecake munching on a cheesecake. Yeah.
Ugh. Like every character, Ruby has a certain switch only she can open. But her switches have certain elements attached to them, which her attacks have to match. So first I have to check the crystal, then scroll through the menus and change the attribute of my ring to match whatever it is. If I don't happen to have that attribute, I'm screwed. Remember when I said the game is wasting my time? I stand by that statement. Well, this is the final level, but where's the boss? All I can find is this music box. Let's play it. A creepy old music box and a 100-year-old wrecked ship? What's the worst that could happen? Ugh, where are we? Notre Dame? Why do I get all the evil music boxes? Ma'am, do you know where... Oh, great. Not even the ghost of the queen is possessed. Right? Right? Fairy King, where are you? Wait, she's not possessed? Oh, great. So the first genuinely evil boss is a pissed off bride left at the altar. Lovely. Ah, jeez, this ghost is hard. I'm calling the professionals.
This chick is toast!
Oh, hey, merchant guy! What are you doing here? Wait, you two know each other? Oh, right, the life sphere. And wait, you also had the moon orb all along? You told me the moon orb is down here, just so I go down and help you get to your ghost girlfriend! You used me! Wait, can I have that life sphere? I can sell it to Joker, make a lot of money, okay, fine, happy ending and everything.